We are discussing probability. Okay. Now today we consider the set terminology, that is the occurrence of events. I think it will be more convenient to you for doing problems on probability. Okay. Now we shall discuss. If we consider one event A, the occurrence of A is denoted by A and its non-occurrence is denoted by A bar, or it is termed as complement of A. A bar is the complement of A. That is, it is the non-occurrence of the event A. Now we consider the case of two events A and B. Okay. We know occurrence of none is denoted by occurrence of none means the A bar intersection B bar, that is not A at the same time not B. So it is denoted as A bar intersection B bar, or it can be written as A union B whole bar, and this result is known as De Morgan's law. Okay. A bar already we have discussed about that. A bar intersection B bar equal to A union B whole bar. Now occurrence of both is A intersection B. A intersection B, that is A and B simultaneously, it is termed as occurrence of both. Okay. Occurrence of exactly one, that means when A occurs, not B occurs, or A or B occurs and not A. That is, A intersection B bar union A bar intersection B. A intersection B bar, that is A occurs but not B, or A bar intersection B, that is not A but B. Okay. Not A, that is A bar, but B is intersection B. So intersection sign may or may not be written. That is A, this is A intersection B bar union A bar intersection B, which is the occurrence of exactly one. Okay. And occurrence of at least one means minimum one, that is either A or B or both, so that it is represented as A union B. Occurrence of at least one for two events is A union B. Okay. Occurrence of at most one, that means maximum one, that is A intersection B, that is both, not both. Okay. That is A intersection B whole bar. A intersection B whole bar. Or by De Morgan's law, it is equal to A bar union B bar. A bar union B bar. Okay. Now, we consider the case of three events A, B and C. Occurrence of only A. So, A happens at the same time not B and not C, and hence it is A intersection B bar intersection C bar. Okay, clear? Only A means that A occurs but not B and not C. So that A intersection B bar intersection C bar. Occurrence of both A and B but not C. A occurs, B occurs but not C. So it is written as A intersection B intersection C bar. Okay, A occurs and B occurs but not C occurs. So that A intersection B intersection C bar. Okay. Occurrence of none means that not A, not B and not C. That is A bar intersection B bar intersection C bar, or by De Morgan's law, it is equal to A union B union C whole bar. A union B union C whole bar. Okay. occurrence of exactly one. Exactly one. That is, if A occurs, not B, not C. If B occurs, not A, not C. If Z occurs, not A, not B. That is, either A, B bar, C bar, or means union. A bar, B, Z bar, union. That means or. A bar, B bar, C. Okay? Once again, A occurs, not B, not C. Or B occurs, but not A, not C. Or C occurs, but not A, not B. Which can be written as A, B bar, C bar, union. A bar, B, C bar, union. A bar, B bar, C. Okay, occurrence of at least one. At least one means union. For three ones, union is given by A union B union C. Okay, again, we reconsider the case. We are considering three events A, B and C. So, at least one means A union B union C. Now, occurrence of exactly two. Exactly two. Similarly, exactly two. That means A occurs, B occurs, but not Z. Or A occurs, B not occurs, but C occurs. Or not A, but B occurs, C occurs. It can be written as A, B, C bar, union. A, B bar, C, union. A bar, B, C. Okay. A, B, C bar means A intersection B intersection C bar. This is A intersection B bar intersection C. And this is A bar intersection B intersection C. Union means or. Okay. Union for or. Intersection for and. Okay. Remember. Okay. Occurrence of at least two. At least two means two or three events can occur. Okay. So that exactly two is written. So that A, B, C bar. Union A, B bar, C. Union A bar, B, C. This is the case of exactly two of the events or two events. Okay. Union, that is or. All the three, A, B, C, A, B, C. Okay. Now, occurrence of all the three is A intersection, B intersection, C. All the three. Okay. Occurrence of at most two means maximum two events can occur. That is, all the three events not occur. So that A intersection, B intersection, C. Whole bar or can be written as by De Morgan's law A bar union B bar union C bar. Okay. A bar union B bar union C bar. I hope it is all these points are clear to you. Okay. Now we consider problems. Firstly, we find the probability of getting a sum 7 or 11 when two dice are thrown. The probability of getting 7 or 11 when two dice are thrown. The probability is obtained by using the addition theorem. 7 or 11. Let me write the problem. Okay, find the probability of getting 7 or 11 when two dice are thrown. Okay, we know the sample space. I am not writing the sample space. We consider the respective events and we write the set set of sum equal to 7 and sum equal to 11. So that we know when to, for the solution, we know when two dice are thrown, we know the sample space consists of 36, that is 6 square, okay, 36 sample points, so that exhaustive cases equal to 36, exhaustive cases equal to 36, okay. Now we consider A as the let A, the event that sum equal to 7, okay, and B be the event that sum equal to 11. A is the event that sum equal to 7 and B is the event that sum equal to 11. Therefore, A is the set, okay. Firstly, we consider the sample space of two dice and we know it can be written as a set of 6 rows. First row is from 1 up to 16. Second row can be written in order we write. Second row is 21 up to 26, etc. Last row is 61 up to 66. So that sum 7 means in the first row 16 is the outcome. Second row 25 is the outcome. Third row 34 is the outcome. 34, then 43, then 52, then 61. 6 months, okay, so that A consists of 6 sample points, therefore favorable cases for A of A equal to 6 and P of A equal to, we know favorable cases by exhaustive cases, so it is equal to 6 by 36. Now we have taken B as the sum equal to 11, so that we know 5, 6, 5th row, okay, 5th row, 6th column, only 5, 6 and 6, 5 gives the sum equal to, what is it, sum equal to 11, therefore, favorable cases equal to 2 and probability of B implies P of B equal to 2 by 36, isn't it? Now, we require either sum equal to 7 or 11, that is required probability equal to probability sum equal to 7 or 11, that is equal to 4, or we use the addition theorem, that is P of A union B. Now, P of A union B is obtained as equal to P of A plus P of B minus P of A intersection B. Now, here consider the events A and B are mutually exclusive as there are no common outcomes. Okay, A is the sum, A is the set of sum equal to 7 and B is the event that sum equal to 11. As there are no common outcomes, A and B are mutually exclusive. So that P of A union B equal to P of A plus P of B minus P of AB, P of A plus P of B minus P of AB. P of AB equal to 0 since A and B are mutually exclusive. P of AB equal to 0 since A and B are mutually exclusive. Okay, mutually exclusive. Therefore, P of A union B becomes, okay, P of A union B becomes P of A plus P of B. That is, P of A union B equal to P of A plus P of B equal to 6 by 36 plus 2 by 36 equal to 8 by 36 is the required probability of probability that the sum equal to 7 or 11. Okay, this is the problem using addition theorem when the two events are mutually exclusive. Okay, now we consider the next case. another problem on addition theorem. The question is, find the probability of getting an ace or a diamond. Okay, find the probability of getting an ace or a diamond when a card is drawn. When a card is drawn from a pack of cards. Okay, this is again from a pack of cards. This is again the application of addition theorem. Okay, what is the case? Let us consider two events A and B. A as the event of getting an ace and B as the event of getting a diamond. Let A getting an ace, event of getting an ace. Getting an ace and B event of getting a diamond. A diamond card. Okay. Now we can write directly this probability. What is it? It is simply P of A equal to favorable cases by exhaustive cases, as we know. And we know a pack of cards contains 4 aces. 4 aces, 13 diamonds. Okay. 4 sets. Each set contains 13 cards, so that 13 diamonds. And there will be an ace of a diamond set. Okay. So that A intersection B possible. Therefore, P of A becomes A is getting an ace. That is 4C1 divided by 52C1 equal to 4 by 52. Now P of B, it is the probability of getting a diamond card. As there are 13 diamond cards, it is 13C1 divided by 52C1. This is out of 13 cards, 1 is taken at a time, so that 13C1 is the total number of favorable cases. So that 13C1 by 52C1 equal to 13 by 52. Now here A intersection B is possible. What is P of A intersection B? That is probability of an ace and a diamond. That means a diamond ace. Okay, so there is only one such card, diamond ace, one such card, ace and diamond. That is 1C1 divided by 52Z1 equal to 1 by 52. Therefore, required probability is probability of ace or diamond. That is probability of ace or diamond equal to, so we apply the addition theorem and hence it is equal to P of A union B. So equal to P of A plus P of B minus P of AB. I hope you follow me. Okay. The required event is probability of ace or diamond. So that P of A union B. So equal to P of A plus P of B minus P of AB. That is 4 by 52 plus 13 by 52 minus 1 by 52. That is equal to 16 by 52 is the answer. Okay. So that here we are discussed two cases of addition theorem. One, as A and B are mutually exclusive, and the other, A and B possible, A intersection B possible. Okay, thank you very much.